Well, it's a pretty peculiar story, if you believe in peculiar stories. How could there be not only a Nazi, but what they consider to be a super Nazi in the middle of the Arizona desert? And if that wasn't peculiar enough, he was a U-boat captain. Now go figure, a Nazi U-boat captain in the middle of the Arizona desert. Well, you'd only hear about something like that on Myth, Legends, and Lies. And I wish the story wasn't true, but you know what? It was. And this is the story about Nazis in Papago Park in 1944. And not only were they in the park, they escaped. And they were loose in the Arizona desert.
J.Schreck, Myths, Lies, and Legends. Where does our journey have us going today? Well, today we're in downtown Phoenix. You might say, well, what the hell's in downtown Phoenix? Well, take a look at this. I'm at a place called Papago Park. Now, what makes Papago Park interesting is this. In 1944, Nazis, yeah, I said Nazis, escaped from a concentration camp at Papago Park in downtown Phoenix, Arizona. Wow. Nazis, Papago Park. Now, originally the camp was built for Italians, but then they brought in Nazis, and most of these Nazis that they brought in were U-boat captains and sailors. And so they got these U-boat people, and they brought them here in the middle of the desert and put them in a concentration camp. Now, the amazing thing about this is that 24 Nazis escaped Papago Park. So, the story goes like this. The U-2 captain was a Jürgen Wattenberg, okay? He was considered to be what they called a super Nazi. And everywhere he went in these prisoner camps, I guess he was considered to be a real pain in the ass. Let's just put it that way. So they weren't really excited about getting him here at Papago Park. Now, if you look at the ground and the terrain, the ground and the terrain are extremely rocky, right? So they expected it would be almost impossible for someone to dig out, right? Or to maybe make a cave. Now, what the Germans did was they wanted to build a volleyball court, right? So they asked for tools, shovels, rakes, and well, guess what? They got their shovels and rakes, right? And what they do next was they dug a tunnel 178 feet long. So in December, 24 Nazis escaped Papago Park prison camp. Now, one thing that they miscalculated, right? When they had got their hands on some of these maps, right? They didn't realize that in Arizona, when they show a river, it necessarily doesn't mean that it's a river. As most people know that live here, most of these rivers are dry. So when they got to the Salt River, now their goal was, is that they were going to get to the Salt River and then they were going to proceed 150 miles to Mexico. So that was the plan. So they had built the raft. And the problem was when they got to the river, well, as most people in Phoenix realize, that river was empty. So, 24 Nazis were loose in Phoenix, Arizona in 1944. And most of them didn't get very far. Most of them, within a couple weeks, they'd captured them. With the exception of Jurgen. Jurgen actually stayed out in the caves up north. And he was out over a month. And he had actually been sending people back and forth into the camps. But he made one fatal move. And that was, he asked directions from a city worker downtown. And the worker realized that his accent was a little funny. And he called the authorities, and guess what? They took Jurgen back, right? Now, as in other escapes, the Great Escape, where American prisoners escaped Nazi concentration camps, where the price was death, for some reason they let him go. For some reason they let him off on a few rations problems, right? And that's the way that story goes. And so when the war was over, Jurgen and his crew, they went back to freedom in Germany. So that is the real life story of Nazis, U-boat Nazis, in the Arizona desert. J.Schreck, myths, legends, and the occasional white lie. But in this case, no white lies. This happened, it's documented, and I still find it fascinating there were Nazi U-boat captains in Phoenix, Arizona.